Traveling began for me as an exploration of two worlds, the world outside and the world within. I believed that through travel I could find myself and my place in this world. A passport and a photo ID were not enough to define who I was. What I failed to realize at that time was that the fact that I even held a document containing my name and declaring a country as my own is a privilege that millions of people in the world do not have and never will have. This is the reality for millions of people from Burma who live in a sort of nightmarish limbo between two countries, on the border of a land where they go unrecognized and a land of darkness. The people of Burma have endured decades of inhumane treatment at the hands of their ruling junta, the State Peace and Development Council, or the SPDC. It is one of the most repressive, brutal, and evil military regimes in the world today. For decades, it has carried out campaigns against its own civilian population, destroying villages, using rape as a weapon of war, enslaving hundreds of thousands as forced laborers, killing innocent civilians, and forcing millions to flee their homes as refugees and internally displaced persons. The levels of poverty are as bad as in Somalia and Sudan, yet Burma receives only a fraction of the aid that other countries get. Europe and the United States have placed economic sanctions on the country because of its human rights record.
So I feel like hopeless, and I almost gave up 2 times in Burma. I feel like Burma has become like a nightmare. I want to run away from the place with nightmare, or I want to escape from the place where with this nightmare.
In countries like Thailand, where the majority have sought asylum, life is not always better. Because Thailand was not a party to the 1951 International Treaty for the Protection of Refugees, the Burmese are considered in the country as illegal migrants.
A lot of Burmese people, they left Burma free and then cross border, came here. Before they cross, they think their life is maybe better, but in reality, their life is not better like they expect before.
Those who fled therefore have no access to healthcare, education, or protection under Thai law. Many are deported back to Burma, trafficked, forced to work in sweatshops, or worse. It is a reality for these people that even the place that they escape to is not safe. The SPDC's attempts to gain total control over the population through censorship and isolation have resulted in thousands being incarcerated. Distributing a supposed anti-government pamphlet can land someone in jail for a minimum of 7 years, where, if they even survive the interrogation period, conditions are inhumane and brutal. Burma's political prisoners are a diverse group. Students calling for an independent student union, monks who overturned their alms bowls at the military's economic mismanagement, poets and journalists writing about poverty and oppression, school teachers and mothers. There are nearly 2,000 of them fighting for their lives inside prison walls right now.
But military didn't shoot. They used the gun and they beat and they torture and they sent to the jail. A lot of people, over 1,000 people, students, sent to the jail.
Some deprived of food, deprived of drinking water. Some were severely tortured. I have never treated by anyone.
How long were you in prison?
I was in prison for 5 years and 9 months.
When you think about your time in prison, what feelings does that bring up for you?
First, I feel really upset. Because at the time I was studying master in physics. I also had a part-time job, quite good income. So I gave up all these things, and I learned that I would be sentenced long imprisonment.
From the moment a child is born in Burma, their life is threatened. Children suffer from disease and malnutrition. They are trafficked, used for forced labor, tortured or executed, recruited as child soldiers into the army, and otherwise subject to direct abuse. Children there will live shorter lives than anywhere else in Southeast Asia. Burma's investment in health and education is among the lowest in the world, but despite the overwhelming need, it is still one of the most underfunded countries on the planet.
We use the mortar, and then go. They start the fire mortar, and then suddenly it became da-da-da-da, and then landing. So when they start, before landing, between that time, I almost forget to breathe. You know, the bullet will come to me, or the bullet will come to my friend, or the bullet will come to my parents. When they go, oh, but and then again, come again, oh, I just come again. Let me just, I never forget that thing. 1994, I have a really, 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 really crazy, I think, even though 16 or 17 years ago, I never forget. I was in the jungle, they tried to kill me. And they think I'm a dangerous for them. Two guys with a gun pick up me and then go to the some place, ask question. And then you're scary, you answer sometimes that you're disorganized or disorder your answers. So they think, oh, it's the beat. They hit with the gun bank. But I'm lucky, after 30 minutes, I mentioned one name, the group know the name, I'm a better. So another point is, some people happen like me, so they are not really dangerous, people suspect dangerous, and then they cannot mention the right person name, and then maybe they die.
I love my father and I love him well. I hope to see him someday soon. I love my father and I love him well. I hope to see him someday soon. 'Cause where I live it gets dark at night. Kind of dark eats up the light. Yeah, where I live it gets dark at night. Kind of dark eats up the light. And you know that mother, I'd be lying. If I didn't tell you, I'm afraid of dying.
Physically. A lot of people in my, especially my village, my community, we are still here. We are not escaped yet.
The actions of the SPDC are not simply human rights abuses. They are mass atrocities. The situation remains desperate in Burma, and it is up to us, as fellow human beings, to use our own liberty to help promote theirs.
I don't feel at home. Bum 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 bum. Like Exodus in my own soul. And I wanna return. I wanna return. Sometimes I don't feel at home. Bum bum bum. Home again, home again. One day I know I feel home again. Home again, home again.
one day I know I feel strong again. Lift my head. Many times I've been told, all this talk will make you old. So I'll close my eyes, look behind, moving on, moving on. So I'll close my eyes, look behind, moving on. Lost again, lost again. One day I know our paths will cross again. Smile again, smile again. One day I hope to make you smile again. I won't hide. Many times I've been told, speak your mind, just be bold. So I'll close my eyes, we'll look behind, moving on. So I close my eyes, and the tears will clear. Then I feel no fear. Then I feel no way. My paths will be made straight. Home again, home again.
I want to say, I'm glad to say, never forget in a human right. Need to hear from each other.
Sometimes I don't feel at home, bum, 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 like Exodus in my own soul, and I wanna return. In again, time to break bread. Got a couple heavy things weighing down on my head. Feeling like a child being lost in the crowd. Just can't understand how things are going down. Kinda confused in the way that we're living. We are always taking, we forgot about giving. Missing how we used to talk about. So, clouds coming in, we better get back home. Don't wanna complicate, just wanna shake hands. Taste fruit and return to the promised land. Where we once laughed, kept our hearts clean. No more enemies, we were on the same team. Sometimes I don't feel at home, bum, 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 bum. Like Exodus in my own soul, yeah. And I wanna return.